Hello friends, the topic which we are going to discuss is condensation. So this is unit 3. The title of unit 3 is phase change, heat transfer and heat exchangers. So we can segregate this unit into two topics, two major topics. One is phase change, heat transfer. So we'll be discussing about two concepts in this phase change, heat transfer. One is condensation, another one is boiling. And the other major category in unit 3 is heat exchanger. So we can expect a problem in heat exchanger topic and either a problem or theory in condensation and boiling topic. So we'll discuss, we'll go through condensation. So normally condensation, as unit 3 title is phase change heat transfer. Phase change is what change of state, change of phase from one state to other. For example, if liquid gets evaporated or a vapor state of fluid is condensed, these are all called phase change heat transfer. So condensation is normally whenever a saturated vapor comes in contact with the surface, which is at normally maintained at low temperature, then the saturated vapor will lose heat and try to condense. And the major key point is it should be a saturated vapor. So that's why then it will undergo a condensation process. And there are two types of condensation. One is film-wise condensation and drop-wise condensation. As the name says, film-wise condensation is condensation normally occur over the surface, and the condensate will form a layer, the film thickness layer. That's what it's called, the film-wise condensation. Normally, it will occur in a clean surface where the surface is very, very less, and a very smoother clean surface we can see film-wise condensation. Drop-wise condensation. So, when drop-wise, as the name says, these type of condensation will occur on the surface where it will condense and form a random droplets that will drop, I mean, fall over the surface. Now we can see in AC ducts, air conditioning system, the condenser unit of air conditioning system, we can see droplets of water coming out. So those are condensation process, but that is happening in a drop wise manner. So now we'll go to the problem now. So this problem in condensation. So I'll read out this. A vertical tube of 50 mm outer diameter. So there is a vertical tube whose diameter is 50 mm and outer and 2 mm long is exposed to steam at atmospheric pressure. So we have a vertical tube whose diameter is 50 mm and the length of the tube is 2 meter and is exposed to steam at atmospheric pressure. The outer surface of this tube is 84 degrees Celsius. So the temperature of the steam, sorry, the surface of the tube is 84 degrees Celsius. So by this you can see is an atmospheric pressure steam. So the saturated temperature of a steam at atmospheric pressure, we know that it is 100 degrees Celsius. So that is a saturated steam that is exposed to a surface which is at 84 degrees Celsius. So whenever this high temperature steam compared to the surface is made into contact with the surface, it loses heat and undergoes a condensation process. So you can either take this as a condenser unit, condenser in a power plant, steam power plant water. So 84 degrees Celsius by circulating cold water through the tube. Determine the rate of heat transfer. So the rate of heat transfer is Q, and also the condensate mass flow rate. So normally mass flow rate is the quantity of condensate that we obtain. So the hints in this problem is, so we have two types of condensation, one is film-wise and drop-wise. Normally, we prefer film-wise condensation. Why? Because we always desire film-wise condensation so that the performance of film-wise condensation is good. So we consider that if any type of condensation is not given, then we have to prefer as film-wise condensation. So in film-wise condensation, if you go and see the data book, we have two types of category. One is horizontal and vertical. So based on the given problem, we have to choose the correlation. Since it is a vertical tube problem, then we have to go for vertical surface film-wise condensation correlations. So we are interested to find the rate of heat transfer, it is Q, and again this, the mode of heat transfer is convection, that's why the rate of heat transfer Q is equal to HA del T. So we have seen this is unit 2, so HA del T. So we need this H is convective heat transfer coefficient. So for calculating this convective heat transfer coefficient, so we can see a correlation for this convective heat transfer coefficient with the condensation part of the data book. can go through this. So for a filamentous condensation of vertical surface, we can see correlation like this. So there you can see laminar and turbulent correlation. So here there is no relevant data to identify whether it is laminar or turbulent. And preferably we choose laminar initially. Later we have to do trial and error whether it is satisfied or not. So the correlation for H is 0.943 into K power 3. K is thermal conductivity of the fluid. Rho square is density of the fluid. G is acceleration due to gravity. H suffix Fg is latent heat of evaporation. And divided by mu L. Mu L is the dynamic viscosity of the liquid. And capital L is the length of the tube. And Tv is temperature of vapor minus temperature of the surface. So from steam table, since HFG, for this HFG, so this is latent heat of vaporization. Since the steam is at atmospheric pressure, so the pressure we have taken as 1.032 by 5 bar. For that, the saturation temperature is 100 degrees Celsius and the HFG value is 22.56.4 × 10³ joule per kg. It will be in kilojoule per kg in steam table. We convert that into joule per kg. And for liquid, we have to choose for the mean temperature. So only surface plus the vapor, the saturation temperature, the fluid temperature plus the wall temperature. So fluid temperature is 100 and the wall temperature is 84. The average is 92 degrees Celsius. So either you can approximate this to 90 degrees Celsius or 100 degrees Celsius. Here I have interpolated and got the data from HMT data for water. So it is data book page number 21. The density, the dynamic kinematic viscosity, thermal conductivity. So you can multiply these two to get the relation dynamic viscosity nu is equal to mu by rho. So to get this mu dynamic viscosity, you can multiply these two, the density and the dynamic viscosity. Yeah, so we'll get the mu value. So G is 9.81. So we can substitute all the values. You can substitute all the values and get H value. And you can please consider this. The H value for all the problems. The H value for condensation and boiling will be normally in 4 digits. So the H is for convective heat transfer coefficient. So the value associated for a condensation or a boiling process is huge. So if you get a value of 0.5 or 1.5 or less than 100, that is wrong. Okay. So by logic, by common sense, we have to understand the H value for condensation and phase change process or any phase change process, the H value is larger. And you can calculate Q value. Q is HA del T. So you have to calculate H. And A, since it's a vertical tube, the surface area exposed for heat transfer is pi dl. So it is pi dl. It is pi dl. And diameter and the length. And the surface area, Q. We got Q. So the mass of condensate by using the, since it's a phase change process, the Q is equal to M into HFG. And we have observed HFG from steam table. And we have calculated already the rate of heat transfer. So with this, you can calculate the mass. So problem is complicated. Thank you.